lot goes on behind the doors of a power plant. From the operation of water treatment, electricity, fuel and combustion, to refrigeration and safety regulations. Let's meet the worker responsible for balancing the operations within a plant, the power engineer. Hi, Gord.
Hi.
Brian. Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Welcome to Crofton.
Thanks for having me.
So you want to come and learn about power engineering?
Please and thank you.
Let's roll this way.
Great.
We've heard the term power engineer, steam engineer, and stationary engineer, all meaning the same thing, just the evolution of the trade itself over the years. It has now become called power engineer. Some people confuse power engineer with an electrical process, but it's not really. We use steam to generate through a turbine electricity. Our primary goal is to make steam, and we make steam for the pulp and paper process. My job is to maintain water level in the boiler. If the water level goes too high, we can put water down the steam line. If the water level goes too low, we can overheat the metal tubing and cause metal fatigue and failure. So we have to monitor the environmental aspect of the boiler, the efficiency running of the boiler, and then the day-to-day mechanical parts and pieces that we have to maintain on the boiler. There are just a multitude of industries and businesses and places that use power engineers, everywhere from your local ice rink to nuclear power plants. Like, it's quite a diverse occupation.
Okay, Brian, now we're gonna head over to the recovery boiler.
Yeah.
It's just past here and around the corner.
Sounds good.
So you can see in there, you can see a bunch of ash and a bunch of hog fuel.
Yeah.
There's air being blown up from underneath, and that's what's giving us enough oxygen for combustion in there.
To become a good operator, you need a good sense of troubleshooting, how to troubleshoot, how to diagnose and look at problems, look outside of the box and look at things to figure things out. That is extremely important value in becoming a power engineer.
So Gord, this is command central for your job.
Yeah, exactly right. This is where we can, we distribute all of the steam to the mill, the air, water, everything gets done out of here. This job holds a fair amount of responsibility. If we go down here, the rest of the mill is going to go down eventually.
Wow.
Typical day, if you're a field guy, it consists of doing rounds on the boiler. We're required to do every 2 hours. You have to go and check your peripheral equipment out in the field to make sure it's running. There are instrumentation that measures process of the boiler, and we need to make sure that those processes are the access to those are kept clean. And then there's all of the auxiliary equipment that's out there, pumps and valves and those kinds of things that from time to time fail. And so we need to go and isolate and put on standby equipment if we have standby equipment. Hopefully we do. Most boilers do. And so there's a lot of manual type labor for the field position.
So what's a regular work week like for you?
Well, it's 2 day shifts, 12 hours each, 24 hours off, and then 2 more night shifts, 12 hours each. And then hopefully we get a nice solid 4 days off.
Oh, that's a nice weekend at the end of it.
Yeah,
all.
That works nice.
You do not require a 4-year degree of engineering in any field. It's not related to a mechanical engineer in any way. An entry-level power engineer into large industry is a fourth class, then a third, then a second, and then a first. Each level of certificate requires X amount of months of firing time in an industry, or you go to a post-secondary institute and take up to your third class. Third and the fourth class are in this size of operation here, typically operators of the process. Second class and first class are typically supervisors and managers. A good aptitude in math will get you through the fourth and the third class level education. If you want to progress to the second or first class level, there's a lot of physics and thermodynamics to go along and a lot of calculations that you need to do for heat transfer and things like that. If you don't like working in a power steam plant in a large industrial boiler, you can come here and get your ticket and look for a hospital job or an apartment building. Rewards of power engineering are the pride of maintaining, for me, a large industrial-sized boiler in a safe manner. So it's a pride in a job well done. Go to as many different plants, processes that you can and observe and see if this is for you or not. Ask people, friends, families, anybody that's in the industry to take them along and show them what's going on.
Well, Gordon, you got a real high-pressure job. Thanks for showing me around.
It's been an awesome day, Brian. I really appreciate it. I hope you learned something about power engineering.
I did. Take care.
Awesome.
Once again, I'm Brian for Career Track, reminding you that this career could be yours. See you next time.